If you can know what your competitors are doing, then you could probably outrank them. In fact, if you were setting up a new business in an area, you may want to know what categories are more competitive, what categories are less competitive. Would it be worth changing my business name so that I can perhaps appear in the top three in a particular area that's not so competitive? Well, to get answers to those questions, you'd have to first of all do some research. And researching what your competitors are doing can take time. So you might have questions like, what categories is my competitor using and ranking well in? What keywords are they using? How often do they post? How many posts have they ever done? Posts, images, keywords, categories can all make a big impact in how easy it is to rank in your area for your particular niche. And because there may be 2, 3, 4, or even 5 categories that you could qualify within, you probably need to think about which one would be your prime category. But how would you know what those categories are? Well, if you could reverse engineer what your competitors are doing, you'd have a good chance of knowing what it is or where the bar is that you need to beat. So if they were regularly, say, producing 2 articles or 2 posts and 5 images every single week, you know that if you could do 1 more post a week than them, a few more images a week than them, that you could get your rankings and your ratings above them too, that there's a good chance you'll gradually improve your ranking in the Google Map Pack and you'll be found then ahead of them and therefore then getting more clients and customers coming to your business. But to do that reverse engineering for posts and for categories, the information's there, but very difficult to find. It's hidden away. Google doesn't really make it clear. And that's why most people go to Plan A. And Plan A is what we've covered in other videos and we've covered on the recent video with the LaRue window cleaning services. Well, what we do is we set up a business and we just then give Google what it requires. So when Google says part of its plan is to give us a logo, give us a cover photo, give us some posts, give us a COVID update, we can fill those things in. That's Plan A. But today we're looking at Plan B. And Plan B is more of the hidden, the secret information that's still available. And there is a tool that's going to save you hours and hours that will give you that information for free straight away. And that's what this video is all about. So I'm going to show you a tool, introduce you to a tool now that's just been released. And it will give you the number of posts, how often they post, the keywords they've used, the categories they rank in and they use, and a bit more information as well, like the dates that they posted on. Now, all that information's available. You can find it for yourself, or you can just press one button and find it automatically within a few seconds. So let me jump in now and show you how it works. And we're going to make a scenario. Imagine that I'm setting up a fast food restaurant in New York, and I'm going to see what my competitors are. Should I go down the vegan route? Should I go down the fast food restaurant route? Would I be better off competing against burgers? What we'll do is we'll just look at 1 or 2 examples of how it works, and then you'll be clear how you can reverse engineer your competition in the coming weeks ahead. Let's imagine we're looking for New York, USA fast food. We're opening up a restaurant. Let's just say we're opening up one around here. So you'd want to know what everyone's actually doing, what the competition is. I mean, if I click on Wendy's, for example, that come up in the top three, and that comes under their fast food restaurant. But it's always good to know what the categories are. Now, what you can do is you can click on View Categories, and this information is actually there within the code. It's a little tricky to find. So it's kind of, even though it's not advertised as to what other categories they come under, you may want to know, do I go up against them in the same categories? So do I want to open a restaurant and compete against, say, Wendy's, which is a big restaurant there? And these are the sections. So they've got the restaurant, hamburger restaurant, and fast food restaurant. But we might feel that we can perhaps come in at a different angle. Maybe we're doing vegan, so we can go vegan restaurant, or it might be some other category that we could be perhaps able to get to number one in, because there's not so much competition. So knowing what the categories are in the big competition can be quite useful. Now, the other thing we can do is just find out, are they posting? What type of ratings are they getting? And how often do they post in the last 3 months? Now, you'll probably know that posting regularly makes quite an impact on how you appear in Google results, particularly in the Google Map Pack. You may also want to be aware that you can talk directly to your customers through these posts, and they do enable quite a good click-through rate if you get it right. Now, what's going on at the moment is the actual Google My Business add-on, which I'll put a link to down below, called Google My Business Crush. It's just crushing through the numbers. So the information's all there. It's just very difficult to find. This automates it. And now it finds the posts that they've been updating and using. And all this is automatically information you can get hold of, but it's just doing the work for you. Okay, so what it does now, it then enables you to see that it's now finished. These are the categories that it has if you wanted to compete in those categories. We can see it's got 2,388 reviews, an average of 4.1. So you're not going to be able to get that number of reviews if you open up as a restaurant nearby, but you can certainly aim to get above the 4.1. They have no description, and that's an opportunity to get keywords in there. So my advice would be the 750 characters you can use here, but if you use the first 200 or so to use keywords that perhaps are related to the characters that you choose or the information you choose here in your categories, try and get them, include them in the first 200 or so words. That'll be helpful. And then finally, this bit here is the bit again that's really useful. PC stands for the fact that if you look here, you've got the PC stands for post count. So that's the number of posts that they've actually put out on Google My Business. Now, we know that Google My Business posts are important for SEO purposes, and that's your opportunity to talk to your customers. And the more posts you put and the more regular your posts are, the more likely it is that you're going to start appearing more and more often and going up the rankings in Google My Business and on the Map Pack, Google Maps, in Google search results for your business. And then this PC, which looks like Go, but it's actually a 9, so it's PC 90. Or this PC 90 here means in the last 90 days or the last 3 months, they've posted 3 times. So you're going to try to use this tool, and it'll be in whatever field or whatever category you're in, but you can do this for all the categories or all the businesses that you want to beat. So potentially you take the top 3, you'd run through the process we've just done here, and then you'd see how often they're posting. And if you click copy here, and that just gives you the dates when they last posted as well. So 10th of May, 22nd of April, those were the 2 beforehand.
Now, according to Moz, less than 20% of businesses actually post on a regular basis. In fact, every 7 days, which is when the post will run out if you don't post another one, every 7 days, only 20% of businesses actually update their posts. So you could easily jump ahead by just making sure that you regularly update at least once every 7 days. So this tool, GMB Crush, is available to download for free. It goes into the Chrome browser extension. So I'll put a link down below so you can download it, and then you can try it and see if it works for you. Now, I will say that it does seem to need quite a few updates because Google keeps changing things. And every time Google changes something, often this breaks the extension. So you may want to update it if it doesn't work the first time round. But from this video, we've seen how posts are really important. And if you're not posting regularly, and if you don't know the difference between the various different posts, so you'll know on there, there's product posts, there's updates on offers, there's information about events that are coming up, there's the COVID update as well. It could be that we're just confused and we're not really sure which each one of these things do. So you're going to need to know exactly how to do it. And I've produced a video now for you to follow right here that will show you what Google posts are and how to go about it. But if you're just starting out and you will just want to know a little bit more about Google My Business and how it can work for your business, then Google My Business for Dummies is a popular video that a lot of people have been enjoying recently. So I'll meet you there.